You've probably encountered a semiconductor today, even if you didn't realize it. From your smartphone and laptop to the cars you drive, solar panels, and the medical devices keeping people healthy, semiconductors are at the core of modern technology. But have you ever stopped to think about what a semiconductor actually does and why it's so important? Let's start with a little history. The discovery of semiconductor materials dates back to the early 19th century, with key contributions from scientists like Michael Faraday, who studied the electrical properties of materials, laying the groundwork for future advancements in semiconductor physics. But the real breakthrough came in 1947, when John Bardeen, Walter Brattain, and William Shockley at Bell Labs invented the transistor. This tiny device revolutionized electronics, replacing bulky vacuum tubes and enabling the miniaturization of technology. Fast forward to today, and semiconductors form the backbone of modern computing, telecommunications, and artificial intelligence. So, what exactly is a semiconductor, and how does it work? If you like content like this and other engineering principles, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to Engineeringness for more deep dives into the fascinating world of engineering and technology. At its core, a semiconductor is a material that has electrical conductivity between that of a conductor and an insulator. This unique property allows it to control the flow of electrical current, making it fundamental in electronic circuits and beyond. The key to semiconductor function is the band gap energy. Unlike conductors, where electrons move freely, semiconductors have an energy gap, known as the band gap, between the valence band, where electrons are bound to atoms, and the conduction band, where electrons are free to move. For example, silicone, with a band gap of about 1.1 eV, is widely used in microelectronics, whereas gallium arsenide, with a band gap of 1.43 eV, is preferred for high-speed and optoelectronic applications like laser diodes and solar cells. Between the valence band and the conduction band, this gap is small enough that electrons can be excited to move under certain conditions, allowing controlled electrical conductivity. The band gap energy determines whether a material is a conductor, semiconductor, or insulator. Conductors, like copper and silver, have no band gap. Electrons move freely within them. Semiconductors, like silicon and germanium, have a small band gap. Electrons can move with external energy, like heat or light. Insulators, like rubber or glass, have a large band gap. Very few electrons can move. The formula for band gap energy is denoted as. So how do we control conductivity? Well, that's done by a process called doping. One of the most fascinating aspects of semiconductors is that their conductivity can be modified through doping, which alters the carrier concentration and mobility by introducing impurity atoms. These dopants create free electrons or holes, enhancing the semiconductor's ability to conduct electricity via the intentional introduction of impurities into the material. There are two main types of doped semiconductors. Number one, N-type semiconductors. They are doped with elements like phosphorus or arsenic, which have extra electrons. These extra electrons move freely, making the material negatively charged. Number two, P-type semiconductors. These are doped with elements like boron or gallium, which create holes or missing electrons. Electrons from nearby atoms jump into these holes, effectively creating positive charge carriers. This combination of N-type and P-type semiconductors leads to the creation of the p-n junction, a critical component in modern electronics. Semiconductors have revolutionized every industry, with modern microprocessors now containing tens of billions of transistors, enabling unprecedented computing power in compact devices. But not all semiconductors are the same. Here are some key types. Silicon is the most commonly used semiconductor, forming the basis of most modern electronics. Germanium is historically significant, but less common today due to its higher cost. Gallium arsenide is used in high-speed applications like satellite communication and radar. Silicon carbide and gallium nitride is an emerging material in power electronics and electric vehicles due to their high efficiency and durability. Organic semiconductors, which are used in flexible electronics and wearable technology. What's the future of semiconductors? The future of semiconductors is exciting. Researchers are working on quantum semiconductors, nanoelectronics, and biocompatible semiconductors. Though challenges such as material stability, fabrication costs, and scalability remain key hurdles in their widespread adoption, to push the limits of computing, healthcare, and beyond. So, the next time you use a device, remember, semiconductors are the invisible workhorses powering our world. As always, stay curious, keep experimenting, and never stop exploring the wonders of science.